Want to know how to do this? Or maybe this? Or even this? Well, then you should stick around, because all of that is in this video. Hi humans, thank you so much for joining me once again. How has your day been? Anyway, this week's video is all about transitions, the different types of transitions and how to create them. We'll be working our way up from the simplest transitions to the most complicated ones that you can create. So let's go ahead and start out with the least complex type of transition, which is just a cut. This is the most basic type of transition possible. You simply transition from one shot to the next with nothing in between. But if you have transitions in mind while you're filming, you can make cuts very interesting. The basic idea here is to make your cuts appear to be invisible or seamless by covering them with large motion. An important thing to keep in mind when you're trying to make cuts appear seamless is to have something consistent in the frame between both shots. For example, we could have the background and me in this shot be completely consistent. But if I snap my fingers, something changes. Please get out of my room, thank you. If you watch Casey Neistat's videos, you'll see techniques like this being used all the time. This next type of cut that I want to talk about is called a whip pan. Now, I've been inside filming for most of this video, but although the weather is not looking very inviting right now, it's quite rainy, I'm gonna go out on my porch to film this next bit. The basic idea of a whip pan is that you're filming your first shot and you whip your camera to the side just like that. Now, okay, get me back inside. That whip is the end of the first shot, and at the beginning of the second shot, you whip your camera in the same direction. Then when you stitch those two shots together, you'll get a fluid transition between those two shots. Another way to make your cuts appear seamless is to cover them with loud sound by extending the audio of your first clip into the second. You'll notice that a lot of people like to cover cuts with claps or snaps. That loud sound helps to make that change in the video less jarring. All right, that's all for cuts. Now let's talk about a slightly more complicated type of transition. That is preset transitions. I call them preset transitions because you can find them as presets in most video editing programs. This includes fades and wipes and zooms and all of the other strange built-in transitions that your video editing program has to offer. These types of transitions go in between two shots, which makes the transition between them more gradual. These types of transitions have a tendency to stand out, so my best tip for making them subtle and making them fit into your video is to make them follow the motion of the shot. For example, if your camera is panning right to left, then the wipe should move from the left to the right. And if the camera is zooming in, then a zoom in transition is more appropriate than a zoom out transition. This makes it appear as if the transition is moving with the video instead of being an addition on top of it. Another way to make these transitions fit into your video is to use sound effects alongside them, such as the very, very popular whoosh sound effect for wipes. A whoosh is kind of that swooshy wind sound that people use. Finally, keep in mind that with transitions, subtlety is key. You don't want to distract people from your video with a flashy transition. So while they may seem appealing, I definitely recommend staying away from transitions that are flashy and over the top, like cube transitions and page turn transitions. Now, another type of transition that is somewhat similar to a preset transition but sort of fuses it with an intro is a bumper, which uses branding as a transitional element. These are often wipes, and the way that they work is basically you have a shot, and then your logo covers the screen, and then your logo goes away, and it's a new shot, if that makes sense. You can see a good example of this on news shows or at the end of any Film Riot video. Finally, the fun part. Custom transitions. This is the miscellaneous category, the none of the above. They're made by throwing together a bunch of different blend modes and other transitions and visual effects, and they're very fun if you're willing to put in the time to create a cool custom transition. One custom transition that I've been experimenting with in my videos lately is blending two sets together. Let me show you a few examples, and then we'll talk about how to create the effect. This transition is created using two shots with a similar motion. If you're in HitFilm, which is the video editor that I use, by the way, Hit Film Express 2017, out now. You should go download it if you're a Hit Film user. If you're using Hit Film, which is what I'm using, then you start by making your first shot into a composite shot. Then mask around the moving foreground of the shot until it is completely out of frame. Make a mask around the foreground of that shot that you want to make the transition around, and mask around it from the point that it covers the entire frame to the point that it is no longer in the frame at all. Or vice versa if you're doing a transition in the opposite direction. Then go back to the editor timeline and place that composite shot over your second clip. Assuming that the two shots have a pretty similar motion, for example, they're both panning left to right, then it should be a pretty subtle change where it looks like the two sets are fused together. And since you are dealing with objects that are probably moving a lot, I would recommend using a good bit of mask feathering. Otherwise, you're gonna get these weird sharp edges and it just takes away from the effect. Finally, I want to talk about this transition where a shot cuts from one shot to the next, but part of that shot stays around, but only in a certain part of the second shot, if that makes sense. And I actually did not even use any visual effects to create this. I didn't have to open a composite shot. This was all done on the editor timeline using blend modes and preset transitions. So I'm just gonna go over to my computer screen and show you how to make that. As you can see, the transition that we're creating right here is where we have our first shot of this guy taking a picture of a nice canyon wall, and then we have what appears to be a cut to the next shot, but we can still see that guy and that first shot in the sky. So we've basically done a sky replacement where we can see this person in the sky instead of the actual sky in the shot. And as you can see, I said I wasn't using any composite shots for this, and that was kind of a white lie. I actually am. But the only reason I have a composite shot open here is so that I could selectively grade a part of this shot so that I can get the exposure right. Anyway, what we're doing on the editor here is basically using the sky as a giant green screen. So ignoring the sharpening here, that's not important. Basically all that I've done, I've left the first shot under that second one. So even when we cut to the next shot, that first shot remains there until it's completely out of the frame and the sky is no longer a part of the picture. So what we've done with our top layer, as you can see, this is the original shot. It's a nice clear blue sky, and I was lucky enough to have a shot. This might not work on every shot. I was lucky enough to have one where the clouds had defined edges and the sky was basically sharp enough that I could just key out that blue and get a pretty good result. And as you can see, it's obviously not perfect, but whatever, it's good enough. Thank you to whoever submitted this, who commented and said that I should do that. So thank you to Griffin Goalkeeping for the suggestion of this effect. And if you are watching one of my videos and you're like, huh, how'd you do that? Or you just have an idea for what I should feature in a future video, please do let me know, because I always appreciate knowing what you guys are interested in, and it really helps me to plan future videos. All right, if you want a little bit more elaboration on some of the techniques that I talked about in this video, Peter McKinnon has a really good video about transitions, including the one where you blend two sets together. And if you want some of the best inspiration on YouTube for awesome custom transitions, click the link right here to check out Ash Taylor's channel. If you've seen any of his videos, they're like 60% custom transitions, and it's great. That's all for today, but make sure you subscribe to this channel because I will be back next week for another filmmaking video editing tutorial. Anyway, that is all for today. Keep creating awesome things, have a good rest of your day, and I will see you next week.